The principal of a top Christchurch school is standing by his decision to ban two students from a rowing competition after they broke security laws at Auckland Airport. There's been widespread anger and concern after the boys' parents took the school to court and had them reinstated in the rowing team. Michael Parkin has the story.
This is St Bede's rowers heading from Christchurch to Lake Karapiro for the Māori Cup in 2013. Their enthusiasm and airport antics captured and posted on YouTube by Jordan Kennedy, who along with fellow rower Jack Bell took it too far on Friday's repeat journey to the Cup by jumping onto the luggage conveyor belt at Auckland Airport and riding it through the rubber curtains.
The boys broke the law. They'd signed a kind of code of conduct before they left, which they very definitely stated there that if they broke the school rules or they broke the law, then they could be sanctioned by being withdrawn from the regatta.
Earning the warnings from police, aviation security and a ban from the rowing event by the school. But the 16 and 17-year-old parents weren't happy to see their sons banned from the Cup and took the matter urgently to the High Court this morning and successfully overturned the school's decision.
If they break the school rules there, then the school reserves the right to withdraw them from that school event.
Jordan Kennedy's father Shane was the St Bede's Rowing Club chairman. He stepped down from the role yesterday and wouldn't be interviewed today.
But in a statement, the parents say their court action was never intended to justify or excuse the boys' behaviour or suggest that St Bede's didn't have the right to punish them, rather that punishment was simply disproportionate to what the boys had done wrong.
But their ability to swiftly take and succeed with legal action against the school is raising questions about the precedent being set.
As I've said before, this is a democracy and parents can choose to use the court processes available to them, and these parents clearly have done that.
Through their lawyer, Jordan and Jack say they accept they will still face some sort of punishment from the school. Michael Parkin, One News.